Hello and welcome to the episode 82 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, the Beatles get a prize for their achievements, film a performance for A Hard Day's Night, and show very clearly how divided they have become. Let's start with a double concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool on the 23rd of March 1962. The Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime and an evening concert. Moving on in 1963, the Beatles played the City Hall in Newcastle-upon-Tyne for the Montez Row package tour. On the 23rd of March 1964, the Beatles were at the Scala Theatre in London. I know, after yesterday's announcement, you were expecting the Scala Theatre in Milan, but this is not the case. Sorry, you can ask for a refund. Anyhow, the band was there to film the fake United Television appearance scenes for their A Hard Day's Night film. In the evening, John Lennon appeared on the BBC TV programme Tonight between 7 and 7.35pm, broadcast from the Live Grove Studios in London to promote his book In His Own Right, published today. John read parts of the book and gave an interview to regular guest Kenneth Alsop. The book was a 78-page hardback containing 31 stories and a series of pen drawings by John, plus an introduction by Paul McCartney. It sold for 9 shillings and 6 pence, about £3.12 in 2020 money. Still later in the evening, the whole band was at the Empire Ballroom in London for the annual Carl Allen Ballroom Dancing Award event. There, the Duke of Edinburgh, Prince Philip, presented them with an award for their 1963 achievements. The occasion was broadcast live during the BBC TV's The Carl Allen Awards between 10.25 and 11.15pm. Moving on to 1967, we find the Beatles at the EMI Studios. After the first recording of the backing vocals for Getting Better didn't go too well, as explained in episode 80 of What a Fab Day, John, Paul and George completed the choirs with take 14. When this task was completed, the song was finished off with an overdub of bongos, hand claps, piano and electric guitar. The session started at 7pm as it was usual at this stage of the band's life, was wrapped up at 3.45pm with Getting Better being mixed in mono. A little curiosity, both George Martin and Jeff Emerick were busy elsewhere tonight, and so the session was in the hands of another EMI engineer, Peter Vince. Busy day in 1970. To begin with, this was the day of the last Paul McCartney session at the EMI Studios for his first solo album. Working in Studio 3, still under the pseudonym of Billy Martin, he assembled and listened the final version of the master tape of the album. The session started at 3pm and ended 4 hours later. As for his wishes, the McCartney LP had been completed in utter secrecy. At the same time, and probably without Paul's knowledge, Phil Spector was in room 4 of the studios, invited by John Lennon, George Harrison and Alan Klein to produce the Get Back tapes. With the 2 takes on the work by Glyn Johns rejected by the Beatles, Spector was called in to assemble an album for the release of the Let It Be movie. Starting from today, Spector worked on the existing tapes. In this session, he completed 2 mixes of I've Got a Feeling, one of Dig a Pony and one of the 909, remixed Across the Universe and produced an extended mix of I Me Mine. This physical representation of how the Beatles had become divided by March 1970 concludes this episode of What a Fab Day. If you want to help me producing even better music-related material for you to enjoy for free, please visit www.simonmas.com/support and find out what you can do. Be fab and show me some love, even by just dropping me a line or two with your comments on my work so far. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.